Chairman Casey, Ranking Member Risch, members of the subcommittee, thank you very much for the invitation to appear here today to discuss Hizbollah. We share this committee's deep concern about the threats posed by this very dangerous terrorist group, its activities, and the support and direction it receives from outside actors. Hizbollah remains the most technically capable terrorist group in the world, and it is responsible for some of the deadliest terrorist attacks against Americans in history. Hezbollah's persistence as a well-armed terrorist group within Lebanon, its robust relationships with Iran and Syria, and their transfer of increasingly sophisticated missiles and rockets to Hezbollah threaten the interests of the United States, Lebanon, and our partners in the region, especially Israel. While we recognize that Hezbollah is not directly targeting the United States today, we are aware that that could change, especially if tensions increase with Iran over that country's nuclear program. On May 25th, Hassan Nasrallah, Hezbollah's leader, gave a speech proclaiming for the first time that Hezbollah will target Israeli and Israel-bound military and commercial vessels if Israel initiates offensive action against Lebanese ports or undertakes a naval blockade of Lebanon in a future conflict. Hezbollah has also made a number of claims recently about the expanding range of its arsenal, with Nasrallah stating that Hezbollah has the capability to hit Ben-Gurion Airport in Tel Aviv. Hezbollah claims to have reconstituted and improved its arsenal since the 2006 war. In early April, we reiterated our grave concerns and alarm to the Syrian government over reports that they provided Scud missiles to Hezbollah. Transferring weapons to Hezbollah, especially longer-range missiles, poses a serious threat to Lebanon's neighbors, especially Israel. Such an action would have a profoundly destabilizing effect on the region, and we have warned the Syrian government directly about the potential consequences of these actions. We're also taking concrete steps to defend against the threat of Hezbollah's missiles. As President Obama and Secretary Clinton have said, our support of Israel's defense remains steadfast, particularly when it comes to protecting Israeli territory from rocket and ballistic missile technology threats. We will continue to cooperate closely with Israel on anti-missile programs, such as the Arrow program and David Sling. The administration has also committed to providing Israel funding for the Israeli Iron Dome short-range ballistic missile interceptor. Our efforts will help ensure that Israel maintains the capability to defend against and mitigate these threats. Iran continues to assist Hezbollah in rearming, in violation of UN Security Council Resolution 1701. Iran has provided hundreds of millions of dollars in support to Hezbollah and has trained thousands of Hezbollah fighters at camps in Iran. Iran is also in violation of UNSCR 1747, which prohibits it from exporting arms and related materiel. In 2009, UN member states reported to the UN's Iran Sanctions Committee three instances in which Iran was found to be transferring arms or related materiel to Syria, a regional hub for Iranian support to terrorist groups, including Hezbollah. While Hezbollah no longer maintains an overt militia presence in southern Lebanon, a result of Security Council Resolution 1701, it has strengthened its militia infrastructure immediately north of the Litani River and in the Bekaa Valley since 2006. Taking all of this into account, I do want to underscore our long-term goal in Lebanon, which Secretary Feldman has referred to, when it comes to mitigating the threat Hezbollah poses, establishing competent and accountable security forces that are responsible for monitoring and securing all of Lebanon's borders, and thus undercutting Hezbollah's flawed justification that it maintains its arsenal to defend Lebanon. Hezbollah's destabilizing actions have a global reach. The recent conviction of a Hezbollah cell in Egypt for spying, plotting attacks on resorts frequented by tourists, and arms smuggling illustrates the group's growing ambitions. In Iraq, we are aware of Hezbollah providing training and other support to Shia militant groups that carry out attacks against coalition forces. Hezbollah's web also extends to Europe and the Caucasus. For example, Hezbollah planned to attack the Israeli embassy in Baku. While this attack was foiled and the perpetrators are now in an Azerbaijani prison, these actions illustrate the group's continued disregard for the rule of law, both inside and outside Lebanon. We continue to urge all of our European partners, including the EU, to take further action against Hezbollah, to cease contact with the group, enact sanctions. We reject the argument that there is a difference between the group's military and political wings. In the Western Hemisphere, Hezbollah has tapped into Muslim communities to raise funds. In June 2004, the United States Treasury Department designated Assad Ahmed Barakat, a Paraguayan, as a specially designated global terrorist under Executive Order 13224. In December 2006, Treasury designated 9 individuals and two business establishments, as working in the Barakat financial network. In June 2008, the USG froze the US assets of 2 Venezuelans for providing financial and other support to Hezbollah. We do note, however, that we have no credible information to indicate that Hezbollah has an operational presence in Latin America. In addition to our efforts with Israel and with Lebanon's security forces, we have taken numerous steps to erode Hezbollah's capabilities. Along with the State Department's designation of Hezbollah as a foreign terrorist organization, which dates to 1997, the Department of the Treasury's Office of Foreign Assets Control has used Executive Order 13224 to bolster the U.S. government's capability to target terrorists' financial networks. A wide range of entities controlled by or affiliated with Hezbollah have been designated under the executive order, including banks and financial front companies, Hezbollah-linked NGOs, Hezbollah's construction company, Jihad al-Bina, and specific individuals. The United States has also taken action against Iranian entities that are involved in funding and supporting Hezbollah. In 2007, the U.S. government designated under Executive Order 13224 Iran's Quds Force, a wing of Tehran's Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps, which has provided extensive support, equipment, and training to Hezbollah. In 2007, the United States designated one of the largest Iranian state-owned banks, Bank Sadarat, for transferring funds to Hezbollah and Palestinian rejectionist groups. Hezbollah has used Bank Sadarat to transfer funds, sometimes in the millions of dollars, to support the activities of other terrorist organizations, such as Hamas in Gaza. The United States continues to take the threats posed by Hezbollah to it, Lebanon, and Israel, as well as the region at large, with the utmost seriousness. We are minimizing the threat and the influence of Hezbollah in the region by mounting considerable diplomatic as well as counterterrorism capacity building and assistance efforts. Let me just say again how pleased I am that you're holding this hearing, and I very much look forward to your questions.